Hi there. So now we will look into audio routings within the digital audio workstations. And in this video, we will look into Pro Tools and how to do parallel processing, sidechaining, and submixes or bus mixes in Pro Tools, specifically from an audio routing point of view. So let's get going with Pro Tools.
Okay, so let's dive into audio routing in Pro Tools. As the basics are same as in Ableton Live, things are just done a bit differently in Pro Tools. And in case of Ableton Live, you had there the audio effect rack. Here you don't have such of a devices, so you need to be doing things a bit differently, but eventually you are able to route audio in and out from the DAW, tracks, channels, buses. You are using inserts and sends, and then you can do sidechain processing and a parallel processing, so and submixing as well. So you can have a, basically a bus into which you route the channels, and then you do your bus mix and a kind of a stem mix there. So let's dive into how to do those in Pro Tools. So yeah, let's start with the fact that let's create few auxiliary channels so that we can create those as our effect channels or return channels as we use them in Ableton Live, just to add some effects into those. So let's do that, and let's insert two of those. So let's do a reverb, and then let's do a delay. And then for reverb, we go and use why not Valhalla vintage verb. And we, of course, as this is a return channel or kind of an effect channel, we leave it 100% wet. And then let's add here also a Valhalla delay. And we leave it 100% wet, as this is a effect channel in that sense, so that we will eventually start sending audio into these channels. And then, of course, you can use your own color coding or whatever to color code these if you want. I leave them as a green one. So then let's add some audio tracks and start audio routing. So let's do first just two simple audio tracks, and let's put them into the end. And now here, basically, let's bring in an audio file into this one, so we can play that and hear sound from it. So let's just go and lower it down a bit, and let's maybe do a cut over here so that we can loop it easily. In this view. So now when we play, we pretty much hear the sound. And of course, now this is actually now routing, and I need to check my defaults, but it's routing it to out directly and not into the master bus, if you noted. So usually you wanna send it to your mix bus, and then from the mix bus you have your global effects for your kind of a master, and from there it goes to out. So usually you can do this also in configuration in Pro Tools, so you don't need to manually set. Whenever you create a new track, it will automatically be mapped on your master bus or mix bus. And then, of course, you could say here that you don't need any inputs as we are using audio files in this demo. So no input to this track, and then it goes to the mix bus in this case. And now when I play, you can see that it goes to the mix, and then from mix it goes to out. And that's basically how you do kind of routing between tracks and buses. And then if you now would like to do some parallel processing, so that you would like to also have some reverb or delay into used with the sound that you have, then from you here you can actually go and you could do it through buses, but then you can go also here and say that, you know, send it to the reverb or delay track. And now you will get a fader that you can use then to select the amount of how much you are sending that audio into the delay track in this case. Now there is nothing. And now there is. So this is basically how you can then do parallel processing. So the audio goes out from here, and then it also goes to delay, but let's make this also to go to the mix bus as well. This goes to the mix bus, so they now everything is summed to the mix bus, and it from there it goes out. So let's play again. And this is basically how you do parallel processing, you could also have any kind of effect here, and you could send it to multiple places. You could even actually go here and send the delayed track into a reverb, so that you have a chain event. So let's pull that up, and then let's go over here. Now once we play, now you are chaining effects in the sense that it first goes to the delay, does a parallel processing with that one, but these are then, this one actually then also goes to the reverb. So there are now two different effects with the track itself parallel processed. And that's how you can do that in Pro Tools. So let's remove these for now, and let's do another thing. What you can do over here as well. Then if you wanna use kind of submixes, so then you can basically create a routing folder. And then you can place these audio files into that routing folder. And then of course, now you need to go here and say that, okay, this goes to the mix bus, but these audio files, they don't go to the mix bus, but they will need to go to the routing folder number one, as it is named number one. And so now it will go, now these both will go to the routing folder. And then from here it goes to the master channel, which I have named as a mix bus, but a better name would be the master channel for that. Anyway, now when you play, you see that now the sound is going from an audio to a folder, a kind of a summing folder, and then from here it goes to the master. And of course now you could apply an effect over here, and then this effect would be now applied to all basically all tracks that are routed through this routing or summing folder. So this is basically where you would do your mix bus or bus processing. Usually you do that with drums and things, so you bring a kick and snare and all those together into a routing folder, and then from there to your master. And then like if... Now they are all basically summed. now they are all summed into folder one, and then from there it goes to the master. And so now we have basically discussed about parallel processing, we have discussed about submixing, how to create a kind of a summing folder into which you sum tracks, and then you can apply effect to all of those tracks that are summed into one. And then we have discussed also how to send audio into different effect channels, for example, or effect tracks with the parallel processing. One thing that you need, or what you can do also, is that in this case, if you would like to dock the main audio, the audio with the kick drum, you would need to do sidechaining. And how to do that is that then you would need to here actually send this audio into a bus, a new bus. And in this case, the kick would go into that bus. So let's play it and send it into that bus. And then you go over here, and then you go and then you bring in, for example, a compressor. And in this case, we could bring in a fab filter proxy, because then here you could also see it then visually how it actually goes. We go to the section of sidechain, we take it external sidechain, then from here you need to actually now select the bus one into which this audio is routed. So so now when you basically go and play, then if you bring the threshold down, you see that the sidechaining audio that is coming from kick is ducking the main audio in this channel where the compressor is. And of course, now I did it like extreme, so to just show how it is, how the sidechaining works in practice. Of course, when you do audio processing and you need to kind of like, based on your taste, do things in a way that you want. But this, I just took it to extreme to show that how sidechaining works in principle when we discuss about audio routing and audio processing within Pro Tools. So I think we have now discovered everything what you are able to do here in the kind of the basics. So like, summing it up, like tracks, how to get audio from those channels, how to use buses, how to use inserts and sends, how to do sidechaining, and how to do parallel processing, as well as submix or stem mix or bus mix, like what we did here with summing folder.
Okay, that was Pro Tools, and next we will jump into Logic Pro X and do the same things in Logic Pro X. Remember to subscribe for the channel for more content, and thanks for watching. Bye now.